what you're looking for, consider me a friend. But I'll break apart and take your heart before the story ends. This is the part where we fall in.
Something that people should enter into without much thought and consideration. God ordains marriage, and it is also symbolic of the relationship that Christ has with his bride, the church. Apostle Paul wrote, "Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also gave himself for the church." God himself said, "It is not good that man should be alone. I will make him a helpmate." Today we are celebrating the bringing together of you both. It is obvious that Arnar and Brooke have chosen to lead their individual lives and begin life together as one. So at this time, I must ask, who gives this beautiful woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I.
Awesome. You may take your breath. You may be seated. Thank you. Proverbs 18:22 tells us that he who finds a wife finds what is good and receives favor from the Lord. Many people search for a good thing and they never find it. But God has brought you two together, and truly his favor is shown on you both. I kind of like the saying that marriage, a good marriage, is kind of like a good trade. Both feel like they got the better deal. And from our talks together, I know that you both feel that way about one another. And that's so special. But also, it's a principle that the Bible gives us. In Philippians 2, it says, "Do nothing from selfish ambition or vain conceit, but in humility consider others better than yourselves. Each of you should not only look to your own interests, but to also the interests of your neighbor." Marriages are successful. They're successful because people learn to put their mate's interests before theirs. Jesus summed it up like this. He says, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart, your soul, and strength, and love your neighbor as yourself." When you can both learn to love your spouse as yourself, and their needs and desires become as important, if not more important, than your own, then true happiness will be found. At this time, I think it's so appropriate that we could have Cassidy come over, and she's going to read a scripture that is right in line with this time that we have. I love that end. Love never fails. Thank you so much, Cassie. Today is the day of new beginnings. You have both come to this place separately. But you will leave here united, together, as one flesh. So are you ready to take this great adventure? I just noticed today that this church is called the White Album Church. I didn't notice that. So to stay with the theme, with the Beatle theme, I think we'll say, are you guys ready to start this magical mystery tour together? All right. Yeah. Here we go. Einar, this woman whom you hold is to be your wife. She has given you one of the most sacred of all possessions, her life, her love. You possess the power to give her great joy. But it is not what you can provide for her in a material way that will bring her happiness. For riches without love is nothing, and the gift without the giver is bare. Einar, your sensitivity to Brooke's needs and her desires, and your willingness to take care of her and share yourself with her is the thing that will bring fulfillment to her life. You are not to remember only the vows that you make here today in the presence of your family and friends, but you are to remember those tender vows that you had in private with her when only God was listening. So Einar, do you now bow in the presence of this company, as you have already promised her that you will be true and you will be loyal, that you will share your fears and your failures, your aspirations and your triumphs, your hopes and dreams, to be patient in struggles, keep her in sickness and in health, comfort her in sorrow and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto her. From this day forward?
I do.
All right. Brooke, this man whom you hold is to be your husband. He will look to you for encouragement, for cheerfulness, for confidence. No matter what the world may say or think, even if others lose confidence in him or turn their backs on him, you must not. You are his refuge, his comfort, his strength, in good times and in bad times. Brooke, your love will be a great support and stability for my life as you yield to God's plan. May your life be the inspiration and your love the protection that he will need to fulfill his role in life well. So, Brooke, do you now bow in the presence of this company as you've already promised, I know, that you will be true, you will be loyal, that you will be share your fears and your failures, your aspirations and triumphs, your hopes, your dreams, to be patient in struggles, keep him in sickness and in health, comfort him in sorrow and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto him from this day forward?
You.
All right. This is something very special that the couple wanted me to charge you, family and friends. So please listen as I ask you to share this vow from you to this beautiful couple here. So please listen to these words. Will you, the family and friends of Einar and Brooke, promise to support and uphold them in their marriage, giving them encouragement through prayer and love, now and for many years to come?
Yeah.
Awesome, thank you. Einar, repeat these words. Brooke, I pledge myself to you to be your husband.
Brooke, I pledge myself to be your husband.
It is my vow to love you and stay by you.
It is my vow to love you and stay by you.
Bringing you joy and giving you support.
Bringing you joy and giving you support.
I will love and cherish you from this day forward.
I will love and cherish you from this day forward.
I pledge my love to you.
Pledge my love to you.
As you are my beloved.
As you are my beloved.
And you are my best friend.
And you are my best friend.
For repeat these words. Einar, I pledge myself to you. It is my vow to love you and stay by you.
It is my vow to love you and stay by you.
Bringing you joy and giving you support.
Bringing you joy and giving you support.
I will love and cherish you from this day forward.
I will love and cherish you from this day forward.
I pledge my love to you.
That
you are my beloved. And you are my best friend. At this time, Brooke and Einar have personal vows that they wish to express to each other. And Einar, I will ask that you go first.
Dear Brooke, you are the love of my life. I promise to love you for the rest of my life. I will rejoice with you when you're joyful, laugh with you, enjoy life with you, and I will strive to make your life the best it could possibly be. I promise to also comfort you when you grieve, listen to you when you share, when you vent, whether you're sad or angry or playful, when I feel like it and when I don't. I will strive to understand you and where you're coming from before seeking to be understood. I promise to be quick to seek forgiveness and reconciliation when I realize I've done wrong or fallen short. I will be quick to forgive when I feel wrong. I promise to communicate openly and honestly and respectfully with you at all times. strive to not shut down, but rather share honestly what's going on. I will seek to come fully to your side. I promise to strive to love you as Christ loves the church and lays down his life to it. To give myself to you, care for you, nourish you, laugh with you, and cherish you. Forgive you when you need forgiveness, give grace and patience, to be strong when you are weak, and to walk with you through it. I vow to pray for you and to never stop chasing God with you. And most of all, I vow to never stop it.
At this time, we'd like to do the ring ceremony. Enter into a solemn agreement to set aside a reminder. You both have selected these rings as a token of the marriage covenant. This ring is an endless circle representing the unbroken ties that bind a husband and a wife together. So you let the Harley pass. So let these rings also be a reminder, a symbol of your love and sincerity. Brooke, this ring I give you.
Brooke, this ring I give you.
As a token of my love.
As a token of my love.
And a symbol that I have chosen you.
A symbol that I have chosen you.
To be my wife.
My wife.
May it be a constant reminder.
May it be a constant reminder.
That I love you.
That I love you.
Good places. Einar, this ring I give you. As a token of my love and a symbol that I have chosen you to be my husband. May it be a constant reminder that I love you. This is something special because Brooke and Einar come to this place in as separate lives, but today they're united as one. So this is a great representation, and it's one that they're going to be able to keep forever in their home to remind them of this day. So I want you to notice this base, this foundation here. but I want you to understand that it's symbolic of the Word of God, that they've decided to plant their feet strongly on the Word, and the Word be that foundation to their relationship. How many know that as a builder, if you don't have a great foundation, your building is could be destructible? So the foundation of the Word. And then next, I want you to notice this cross, but it's kind of plain. This cross symbolizes the husband, Einar. This symbolizes you. Guys, we're not much to look at. I mean, we're kind of plain. But we are called to be the priest of the home, the covering of our wife. That's exactly what this represents. So at this time, I'm going to ask Einar to place this on the foundation. This represents Brooke's life and all the beauty of the woman. God saw proper that, guys, we needed help, and so he gave us the woman. And the woman brings the beauty to our relationships, but she also brings the temperature of the home. She brings just that strength that we need to fulfill our role in life well. So, Brooke, at this time, if you would place this in the front. So here they are, but I want you to notice something, that the cross is wobbly. In fact, it can fall apart. It could come out. It doesn't stay together very well. There's something that must hold this together in place. And so we have these three spikes that represent, they're in the shape of a actual nail that remind us of what Jesus did for us at Calvary, but there's three of them that represents God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. And when they are placed in this union, which is what's happening today, I'm going to place the first one. You notice that it holds it together. Now if you would place this on the side. Now the stability is in place, and this union is set. And I'm so glad that today is the day of completeness and fulfillment. So let's pray. Dear Father, we thank you for this awesome day you've given us. You've blessed us with beautiful weather. But Father, I want to thank you for the path, the road that led these two, first of all, to you, but then to themselves, to each other. For today is completing something that you had planned a long time ago. So we thank you for that, and we ask that you bless this time together as we celebrate this beautiful union. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. I also think it's very appropriate, now that they are husband and wife, that they've chosen as the first act to have communion together. The Bible says, as often as you do this in remembrance of me. So we're going to have a private time, and you may go ahead with the music. And then after this, Brooke has chosen a time of worship. And so that's what we're going to do. Please bear with us. is just a time of worship, just to enjoy this song and give honor to God. So feel free to stand if you want, but just reverence God at this time. Okay, here we go. Now as you, Brooke and Einar, you've made it clear your wishes to be united in marriage, in the presence of God and before your family and friends. You pledge love and faithfulness, each one to the other. I, as an ordained minister of the gospel, I do now pronounce you husband and wife. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Einar Andre Krupp.
For the fun of it is no longer my game. I'll take got your lovers in. I put them all to shame.
The wedding party's gonna take some pictures, and before we go in we're gonna spend about an hour right out here for refreshments and just to take some time out here. It's beautiful today, so enjoy yourself. Thank you for coming.